Have we received any communications from the planet?
Nothing.
Well, I guess it's only us three then. Where's Zenus?
He's been running atmospheric checks of the planet. If not careful, we could run out of resources within a week.
What about the excursion team? Have they made any progress?
I've lost contact with them yesterday. Yeah, I fear the worst.
As do I. They were our last hope. Our last chance for survival. Ah, Zenus, there you are. How did the checks go?
Not good. The planets have been completely covered in the chemicals. The air has been completely polluted.
Dear God, our people.
They're most likely not our people anymore, Null.
Don't talk like that, Caleus.
But how am I supposed to react? The planet's been at war for ages. Then they throw a load of bombs at each other, and now the planet's a nuclear wasteland.
Yes, I know. But we have to focus and try and sort this out.
Well, we might have more serious issues at hand.
What do you mean? What's happened?
While doing the check, something came up on one of the scans. Some kind of object heading towards the planet.
Probably just some kind of debris in space.
What kind of object is it, Zenus?
Let me get it up on the screen and I'll show you.
What the hell is that thing?
Don't know, but it was picking up speed.
Very strange. A blue box.
Right, old girl. Nice bit of maintenance on the console. You should be working at full capacity.
Well, that was insane.
What happened?
Well, I was on my way to the kitchen to get some food when all of a sudden the door to the room disappeared. Right in front of me.
What?
Yeah, it was really weird.
Well, it might have been down to the maintenance.
What have you been doing?
Some routine maintenance. Very overdue. Ah, yes, I see. Kitchen has been relocated.
What have you been doing?
I was working on the console, and it appears I may have moved the room accidentally.
To the point that it just makes rooms disappear.
Well, it's a small side effect. Continue to shift the rooms around so that the system reboots.
Right. Well, can you warn me next time?
Apologies, Miss Anderson. How about I take her somewhere to eat instead? How about the...
Whoa. What the hell was that?
Oh, I'm not sure.
You haven't moved too many rooms around or something?
Now is not the time for jokes. We could be under attack.
Well... What's wrong?
Ah! System's gone into lockdown. I can't access the flight controls.
What does that mean?
We're spiraling. Out of control. We could end up anywhere.
Oh. Brilliant.
Hold on. Hazel, you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm here. A bit bruised, I think.
Here, let me help you up.
Ow, thanks. Are you okay?
A few bruises, nothing major.
Oh, good. Just one question. Where are we?
Give me a moment.
TARDIS has seen better days.
Indeed she has. But luckily the auxiliary power kicked in at the last second, shielding us from the impact.
Didn't feel like we were shielded.
Only problem is the auxiliary power at the moment lasts for less than half an hour. We need to get out of here to allow her to do the repairs.
Oh. So what do we do now?
Doesn't seem to be any changes to the planet.
Indeed, I am, however, reading high levels of radiation around the crash site, much different to what was contained in the bombs.
What? Let me see.
Can we zoom in?
Probably. One sec.
What the hell is that thing?
It looks like the box. The same box as before. It says as much on the signage.
Yeah, I've been trying to scan it for any sort of contents, but the readings, it's all inconclusive.
What do you mean?
It's saying that the interior dimensions are far more widespread than the exterior ones. It's bigger on the inside.
Must be a fault in the computer.
Yeah, your servers must be on the frizz.
There is no fault.
Then what do we do about this? There's only us three here.
Well, why should we do anything? We could just wait up here until help comes and then tell them about it later.
But what if it already has?
I don't follow.
You mean the box?
Yes. But if that box down there is resources to help us sent by the others who fled, a way to survive.
No, really?
I mean, what if it's a small team sent to help find a cure to the Mutos?
I doubt it.
Caleus.
What, are we going to act like they're one of us? They're not even our people anymore, Zenus.
They might still have a chance.
Yeah, whatever's in that box could potentially help save our race from near extinction.
And it could also be another bomb that could nuke us.
Do we really look like we have any other choice right now? There could be weeks' worth of resources. No said that's not going to last long.
Right, we go down there. Just get the stuff. Get out just as fast.
Sounds like a plan.
Then let's do it.
Doctor? What's taking so long?
One moment, just need to find the second one.
Second one of what? Look, we need to figure out where we are and how we're going to get out of this mess.
As much as I appreciate your perceptiveness of the situation, we need to access how we approach it.
What are you talking about?
Well, think about it. The scanner's down, so we have no real idea of what's out there, but we have to take precautions.
And that's why you bought out these?
Radiation suits. Well, suits generally work for most situations in regards to space and radiation.
All right. So we're going outside then?
Indeed. The TARDIS needs time to fully repair herself, and we can't be here for it.
So how long do we have to wait for the repairs to be done?
Possibly a few hours.
A few hours?
Yes, but we should be safe. These oxygen tanks are about a 15-hour usage, and we should be fine.
And what if it's still not ready in 15 hours?
I doubt we'll be in that situation, Miss Anderson. Now, helmet on.
Found anything?
I'm trying, but the radiation's affecting the readings. I can't be sure I'm getting any correct information out here.
Oh, great. So what, should we just wait around here until the box is ready to fly again?
We could. But I would like
Don't you say it.
What?
Suggest we explore.
What's wrong with that? I haven't been here before.
Oh, that's exactly what gets us into trouble.
Not always. Could be interesting.
Really?
Hazel.
What's that? It's above us.
Must be a ship entering the atmosphere. Look up. You can see the clouds shifting from the air pressure.
It's landing.
I think we have visitors. Wait. I recognize the symbol.
Doctor, are you all right?
Who are you both? Where are your resources?
What?
Caleus, please be kind to these people. Now, identify yourselves.
Oh, well, I'm Hazel, and this is the Doctor. Doctor. Are you all right?
Oh, yes, sorry. Hello.
Are you feeling unwell? Has your seat leaked?
Oh, no. It's just... you're Mekkons.
We are. Now, where are your resources?
Tell us. Patience.
Where are they?
I'd like to ask. This is the planet Mekk. After the chemicals have been dropped?
The chemicals?
Yes.
Ugh. What do you know? What did you do?
Please unhand me.
Hey, get off him! Stop it!
Caleus, get off him!
Stop! Please!
I didn't have anything to do with it.
Then how do you know? This planet was bombed to dust and ash only a matter of days ago. Our people, separated and broken.
We just crashed here. How would we know what's happened?
Okay, everyone calm down. Now.
Okay, may we explain, please?
Yes, please do.
Hazel and I travel around in that box over there.
The capsule we homed in on?
Yes, it's a ship. But something went wrong with our systems. We need to wait for the ship to fix itself in a way.
How long will that take?
A matter of hours.
The lesser the better.
Caleus, please.
So where were you? Your ship came into land.
We blasted off when the first chemical dropped. Thought everyone would do the same, but they left a little bit after. We didn't know what was happening.
We tried to make contact, but our comms picked up nothing. We were left drifting.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We are now running low on resources. Before the attack, we had sent out for new food and survival kits. We were hoping to intercept it before it headed for the planet. We are still with no resources, no contact, and no way of survival.
There's got to be something here. Doctor, couldn't we take them in the TARDIS?
It's possible, but that leaves us waiting for the repairs to finish.
Wait, so are we in danger?
Aside from the radiation, it's quite literally all around us. So we'll need to find some cover very soon.
There is a main central Mekkon dome, but it was hit by some of the bombs.
The damn Trigonians. They blasted the whole place into the Dark Ages. We were a good race once. And then that war occurred. Now look at us, barely surviving.
It'll be alright, Caleus. We'll find a way.
Will we? Or will we just end up like our brothers and sisters? Dead or worse?
If I could interject for a moment, we have met Mekkons before. There is a way of survival for you all. Well, in some cases, life forms can adapt to the new climate.
It is possible to some extent, but the chemicals...
might have mutated them, yes. But maybe we could treat the Mekkons in some way.
What are you thinking, Doctor?
I think the dome might not be completely gone. Our best option right now is to head there and find any equipment that might help. Possibly some clean, breathable air, too.
You really think that will work? Will there even be breathable air?
It's worth giving it a shot.
Exactly. It means that we can conserve our oxygen in our suits.
Give us a moment.
No problem.
They don't trust us.
Two strangers appearing out of a blue box on the wastelands they once called home. Trust for them is very hard to come by, Miss Anderson.
So they're Mekkons?
Yes, but a very different variant of the species.
They're not like the ones we saw on Starbase.
Those were hybrids. Ones who are exposed to the radiation for longer. These are the original ones. But it seems like we haven't used their mortal sphere yet.
So they're like what cavemen are to humans?
In a way, yes. Did you notice how they were wearing suits like us? Their bodies should be able to withstand the atmosphere, but it seems they still have their original biology.
So what should we do?
Listen to them. Find a common ground. And a solution shall reveal itself.
Great. A 50-50 chance of survival.
I don't think it'll come to that.
So what do we think?
I don't trust them.
You don't trust anyone.
Is that wrong?
It is valid, but they do have expertise, especially that doctor fellow.
But what if this is just to lead us into a trap set up by the Trigonians?
Give them a break, Caleus. There's people who are stuck here, same as us.
He's right, and in the same position, our air supply is depleting rapidly. Sooner or later, we will be exposed to the same chemicals as our brethren. We have to act fast.
That dome may be our only hope.
All right, but if they show any signs of a double cross, I will kill them.
That makes you feel better, yes.
So we are in agreement. Good. We accept your terms.
Ah, very good.
But know this, any signs of a double cross...
And you'll kill us. Yeah. We've heard that before. So many times.
I promise we'll do everything in our power to help you. Whatever way we can.
Right. Well, we should get going.
So, are you all close?
What?
Sorry, just... making conversation.
Well, we've all been friends since childhood, looking out for one another. When the war started, we all teamed up, fighting alongside one another. And when the chemicals fell, well, we just couldn't leave each other.
Strong bond.
Have to have one, especially in these times.
How long was the war going on before?
There were hostilities for a really long time. It was a war of words and actions. At least it was until a few days ago.
Sorry.
It's what we have to live with. Null here is like a little annoying brother to me.
He's the older, grumpier one. We try our best.
Are you sure what you're saying is true? Can we find a way to bring our world back from the brink?
I believe so.
I just don't know why you'd want to tell us anything. You seem to know so much about our race, more than... we ever even know.
Let's just say Hazel and I have seen things that the Mekkons have done out in the stars.
Do you think they'll bring some of those amazing things back here to us?
Oh, I don't doubt it. Now, we should be at the dome in no more than 5 minutes.
Get off me!
Caleus! Get off them now! Caleus, are you alright?
I'm okay.
What the hell is that thing?
A mutant. Seems that whatever the chemicals did to the Mekkons who stayed behind, it must have made them mad and rabid.
Those are our people, my God!
Don't worry about those things. What about me?
One moment. It seems to have ripped open your suit.
What's that?
A medical device. Does a lot of things.
Precisely.
Well, what's the diagnosis?
Caleus, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Tell me what's going on.
You've been exposed to the chemicals in the atmosphere. Your body's slowly beginning to mutate.
What?
No, this can't be.
I'm afraid it is. Oh, Caleus,
Look, it's all right.
Caleus!
No, back away.
Why?
He's beginning to mutate. We have to leave him.
What? Doctor?
No. Hazel, the situation is dire. We can't let any more of us be infected. We've got to get to the dome.
We're not leaving him!
No, the doctor's right. There's nothing we can do for them now.
You're just going to abandon them.
Shut up! Let me hurt you. We don't have time for this. You have to find that dome.
We have to go now.
Damn it!
I'm sorry, Caleus.
Just find a way to save us, please.
We will, Caleus. If anything, I can promise you that.
Thank you.
We haven't got much time. How do we enter?
My device should be able to unlock the mechanism in the next 2 minutes.
2 minutes? We'll nearly be exposed by then.
Should be fine. Just give me a moment.
Damn it!
No!
You two,
stay here and try to sort out the door. I'll talk to him.
Don't go too far, Miss Anderson.
I'll be fine. Don't worry.
I'm sorry this is happening, Zenus.
It's not your fault, Doctor. I just don't know what to feel. I'm trying to be strong like Caleus was for the sake of Null. He's the youngest. He was barely full grown before all this started.
Well, let's hope that you can all outlast this.
One can only hope, Doctor.
Indeed.
No. Are you all right?
Fine.
Oh. It's just... you stormed off there, and...
Okay, maybe I did. I'm sorry.
I get you're angry, but... right now, we can't...
Can't what? Lose ourselves? Look what just happened to Caleus. Gone.
We can find a cure. A way back for all of them.
Like what your doctor friend keeps saying.
Yeah. And he's right.
How do you know?
Look. I shouldn't be saying this, but... we're not even from this time. We've been all over the place, different times, planets. We've seen what becomes of the Mekkons. Your race will live on. You've just got to give it a chance. A chance to find itself and regrow into something better.
How do I know you're telling the truth?
You really think that blue box is just a normal ship?
That's true. Okay, Hazel. I'll do it. We'll do it.
No! Watch out!
Hazel! Back! Get back! No! Caleus! No! Wait! Hazel, are you alright?
I don't know. I feel... oh... oh... hazy.
We have to get you back to the doctor. Now!
So, are we good?
Should have enough time to get in and relock it. The air pressure should allow us to breathe without the suits.
Doctor! Zenus!
No! What happened?
Hazel!
We were attacked. It was Caleus. He tried to get me, but Hazel...
heroic as ever, Miss Anderson.
Oh, shut up, Doctor.
Doctor, she doesn't look too good.
I know.
Doctor...
oh no.
Right. Help me with her. Should take a moment. Hopefully the system lasts long enough for me to...
Doctor, I don't want to rush you, but...
I know, I'm working on it.
Those things get in. We're finished.
They won't. Right. They're locked out. For now.
For now?
We have no time. Null, help me with her.
She's not mutating.
No. Her biology is different to yours. It's reacting abnormally. Hazel, can you hear me?
Oh. Doctor. Doctor.
You're going to be all right. I promise.
I'm sorry. I wasn't good enough.
Don't talk like that, Miss Anderson. You're going to be okay.
If I don't make it, tell my mum.
It won't come to that, I promise.
No, if everything feels so... so dizzy. I feel like I'm gonna...
No, Hazel, stay with me.
She's not looking too good.
Sorry.
Hazel! Hazel!